God bless you. Thank you for being with us today. We are Abundant Grace Church. I am Bishop Ramon DeMaria, and I am the senior pastor of the church. For prayer or information concerning our ministry, please email me at abundant.grace@att.net. My message title today is The Right Path. I will be reading from the book of Psalms, chapter 1 and verse 6, which reads as follows. The Lord watches over the path of the godly. My beloved, do you need direction today? If so, seek God, and He will speak to you. And He does that through different ways. One, through relationships. Sometimes He will give you direct revelation, but often He will speak to you through relationships. His word says, remember your leaders who spoke the word of God to you. You can read that in Hebrews chapter 13 and verse 7. So let me ask you this, who speaks into your life? To whom are you submitted? Without good input, you will live unprotected and undirected. Two, through your gifts. A man's gift makes room for him. That's Proverbs chapter 18 and verse 16. When God is directing your steps, you won't need to kick the door open and force your way in. Your gift will bring a solution and meet a need. Therefore, my beloved, you are welcomed, valued, and rewarded. Three, through your thoughts. We have the mind of Christ. You can read that in 1 Corinthians chapter 2 and verse 16. When our minds are renewed by His word and lined up with His will hear from Him. So my beloved, remember this. God actually thinks through us. Consider what an advantage that is. Four, through open doors. Paul wrote, for a great door and effectual is opened unto me, and there are many adversaries. That's 1 Corinthians chapter 16 and verse 9. You see, my beloved, God will open doors for you, but you must remember that with every opportunity He gives, challenges come also. That's what builds your faith, my beloved, and strengthens you. He gives challenges, my beloved. Without a challenge, you will never gain strength. You see, challenges are what builds your faith and strengthens you for the future. Five, through a word of confirmation. Isaiah chapter 30 and verse 21 reads, thine ears shall hear a word behind thee, saying, this is the way, walk ye in it. My beloved, note the word behind. The word comes after you obey God, letting you know you've made a good decision and that you are on the right track. Yes, my beloved, you can be led by God. His word says, the Lord watches over the path of the godly. Let us pray. Father God, teach us to hear your voice. Teach us to listen to you through relationships, through our gifts, through our thoughts, through open doors, and through a word of confirmation. Thank you for guiding us in the way that you will have us to go. And we pray this in the name of our Savior and Lord Jesus Christ, to whom be glory, power, and majesty, now and forever. Amen. My beloved, if you need direction today, listen for God, for He will speak to you, whether it's through others, through your gifts, through your thoughts, through open doors, or through a word of confirmation. The thing is, you must be alert and listen. God bless you and go with God.